who's just left Mukono town and embarked on the 80-kilometer journey to Galilaaya sub-county in Kayunga district. On our way, we met this elderly woman pushing a bicycle with a basin and a jerrycan of water. She says this has been her routine for several months now, after the only valley dam in the sub-county dried up due to the prolonged drought.
Kati omanyi je bayita enakatuli je garumbi eyo enakatuli kubidamu eyo je mvogaji
mailo ngamu
zilinga mailo 5 okutuukayo.
The elderly lady is not alone in this predicament.
Amazi gagwayo ebidamu byonna byakamira kakati damu eri misanga je tukimamu amazi
kati saawe enoze je ngenda badde ngenda kunyanja misanga mailo nga 10 okunona ya amazi
chone president Museveni mukubira omulanga nti yatugama mubiri mukaga nti egombola Galilaaya bagenda tuwa ebidiba mukaga nebidiba mukaga ebyo nokutuka na kulwalero tetubifunanga.
This is the valley dam that has been serving the people here since 1962, the year Uganda got independence. The dry spell has made things worse for a dam that has suffered decades of poor maintenance.
Bali techimoro kaneba fuwamu amazi nga gafana na gayero abantu nga tosoa ganywa tosoa gakozesa era review na bena tetwina kituyambi bawadde nakatono.
A 20 liter jerrycan of water here goes for about 2000 shillings, and those like Nabanja who can't afford have to trek long distances in search of water. The boreholes are few and inefficient. The major water source for the residents of Galilaaya sub-county is Kawango landing site on Lake Choga. It's over 20 kilometers away, so one may need half a day or more to travel to and from the landing site. But even after you've made it to the landing site, you may have to hire a boat to access clean water deeper in the lake. Warn to you, if you can't afford hiring a boat, for you will have to take home dirty water from the shores. Getting food is also a challenge here since all crops dried up. This farmer, Bosco Sonko, borrowed money from a bank to boost his maize farm, but now he's counting losses.
Naje loni ya bukadde wali bukadde butano nga nsubira nti singa mba nkoze nkusinzira ku bbanga lye maze mu nga nnema nga nsubira ngiza okufuna mu bukadde obwere 15.
This is serious here. I mean, look, I have moved almost these 15 acres just trying to look for one piece of fresh maize crop, but I've really failed to find one. It's now the animals eating it up, and they also need to survive anyway. Wow.
Maize flour is seen as the best option for food here, but it's also expensive because many maize gardens dried up. Now, residents buy sweet potato peelings, which they dry in the sun and later make flour out of it.
Tuba tubyanikiriza, tusekule sekule, tufume tufune ekyokulya, tuli bubi tata.
Animals are also suffering, with many dying. Residents are worried, hopeless and helpless. Their only prayer is that government comes to their rescue with food and aid sooner rather than later. Solomon Kawesa, NTV.